Increasing students' motivation by providing meaningful and fun activities is something that teachers should always have in mind. The creation and development of making-based activities allow students to be more engaged, while learning to develop key competences such as critical thinking, creativity, or problem solving. In this video, we are going to learn how to use the microbit to create different activities that you can integrate in your curriculum, such as an escape room. We're going to teach you Morse code or an automata. And you can build it with your students. But before we start, let me give you an overview of the microbit. The microbit is a pocket-sized computer designed to bring computer science education and STEM to every student. But you can also integrate it in any subject as a cross-curriculum activity, where your students can learn about history, solve mathematical problems with an escape room, or use it in your STEAM lesson to create an automata, and much more. Your students will be learning while having fun and develop their ICT skills. The microbit allows students to create all sorts of creations such as robots, musical instruments, escape room, and much more. The microbit has 25 programmable small LEDs and 2 buttons. There are different sensors on board like temperature, light, and an accelerometer. You can add different kinds of electronics like a speaker, LED lights, servo motor. There are plenty of possibilities. Do you want to discover a few of them? Keep watching. So in this video, I'm going to show you a few examples of the activities you can carry out together with your students, regardless the subject you teach. The only thing that you need to carry out these activities is the microbit, together with some inexpensive materials like carton, an old speaker or a box, keys and locks, crocodile cables, and a 360 motor, servo motor for the automata. For primary students, you can make, for instance, a Morse code lesson with your microbit. The students will learn about Morse code and discover how to send secret message to each other. For doing this activity, you only need some cables, a microbit, and a piezo. We also designed a worksheet for you, where they can write in the code and translate it to Morse code. In the Code Week website for schools, you will also find an example of the code for students, what they can put on the microbit. This Morse code can be used, for instance, to teach students about history and the Second World War. For secondary students, you can go a bit further and create, for instance, an escape room with different puzzles on the microbit that can easily be connected to a mathematics class in or a project. To do this activity, you would need some locks, a suitcase, and creativity, and they do lots of problem solving. Another class can try to open the box, and in this box, of course, is a prize, like some sweets or cake. If you are interested to know more about to create this escape room, go to the Code Week website for schools, where you will find some examples of the code for your students. But I'm sure they will come up with lots of ideas to make puzzles or other difficult clues how to open the box. For higher secondary students, you can go even further and create an automata together with them. If you want to bring this activity to your classroom, follow these steps. For this activity, you will need some materials such as carton, glue, pistols, duct tape, microbits, and a 360 servo motor. You can start the lesson by explaining your students what an automata is and how it works. Then you can show them some examples of automata such as these ones. They will start by making the automata, and it has to be hand-driven first. Take an old small box. Make it more sturdy. Cut 4 circles. Glue the circles and the wooden stick. Let it dry. Take another wooden stick and put it through the box, like horizontal. Make a hand-driven part and glue the circle in the middle on the horizontal stick. Make a hole on top of the box, put a straw in the hole on the top. Put the other stick through the hole and put that stick on the other wheel. Turn the wheel by hand. just a bit so it turns good. Put the code on the micro bit for the 360 motor. Now attach the motor to the turning stick. Making the Automaton is lots of trial and error, and you have to use duct tape, creative thinking and problem solving. If there is time, or you have really quick students, they also can use the micro bit as a remote control for the Automaton. When all the projects are done, the students have to present their Automaton. And if you're interested to do this activity, make sure you check the Code Week website for schools, where you will find the code to move the 360 motor and the code for the micro bit as a remote control. This will help you to do this activity immediately. This kind of activities help students to develop their critical thinking and problem solving, and students will learn while having fun. And you will be helping them to be active creators of technology, rather than being only consumers of technology. Most important, these activities are also suitable for students with no coding skills or experience. So we really encourage you to try out one of them with your students. I have 5 tips for you. To download the code from the computer to the micro bit, use the new pairing device under the settings in the makecode.com website. When the micro bit is paired, the downloading is a piece of cake. 2. To connect a speaker or headphone to your micro bit, make sure the crocodile cables don't touch each other. And one side has to be at P0 and the other at the ground. 3. You can make a starting code for your student and share it with them, so they are quickly on the way to make the code and put it on their micro bit. 4. With the servo motor, make sure that your battery is full and connected to the right colors of the servo to the micro bit. Take a good look in the lesson plan. And 5, of course, when you are doing this, there is one thing you should always consider. You have to think big, but start small. Now that you know some of the fun activities you can do with your students, why don't you try them in your classroom? Go to the Code Week website of schools, ask your students to choose one of the lessons, plans, and you will find there and do it together with them during Code Week. And if you do so, remember, of course, to add your activity to the Code Week map. Wait no more. Participate in Code Week. Have fun with your students.